Welcome to Johns Hopkins, one of the most prestigious institutes of graduate education. We here at Hopkins want to welcome you with open arms, and we want you to know that you'll be taken care of, because we care about you.
No, not you. No, no, not you either. Yes, you. Wait, well, okay, you.
In order to prepare you for what will likely be the greatest 4 to 12 years of your life, we here at Hopkins have some guidance to help you become part of our family. Isn't that right, Susan?
My name is Beth.
Fantastic. Let's take a walk, shall we? Here at Hopkins, work together to create a happy and encouraging environment, helping find solutions to the problems that matter. We know that the road to Hopkins was a trying one. Long nights spent trying your best to stay awake to study for the next day's big exam.
Being subjected to demeaning undergraduate slave labor.
Spin these down for me, would you?
Do I have to?
Spin! Faster!
And having to suffer through that awful GRE.
You here for the GREs? Alright, so I'm going to need 3 forms of ID, a social security card, your birth certificate, and your voting record. Also, so I'm going to need your electronics, jewelry, wallet, shoes, shoelaces, belt buckle. Just sign here and there. No, don't sign there. Sorry, also I'm going to need you to transcribe the first 15 chapters of War and Peace in cursive. Got it? Good.
And after spending all that time, money, and effort studying for that big exam, you may realize you're not as smart as you thought you were.
What happens if I'm finished and I still have time? Can I play on my Game Boy?
The long nights spent studying, the undergraduate research, and all the strenuous testing has all finally paid off. But before you start here at Hopkins, there are a few things you should know. Isn't that right, Katie?
Who are you?
First things first.
Graduate students here at Hopkins have access to a plethora of housing options, such as spacious studios for the single grad student life.
Can I help you?
Or for you hard-working grad students, housing options exist closer to the campus.
Good night. See you tomorrow.
Or you can cut down on costs by living with a roommate.
Welcome!
Or, for the more social grad student, multiple roommates might be desirable.
Hey, has anyone paid the water bill yet?
No.
Thanks.
Yep.
Now that you've joined the elite ranks of graduate school, you'll see that your focus will shift to real-world application. It's time to turn all that theory into action, knowledge into practice. It's time to get your nose out of those books and your hands deep into that science.
And you know how you're going to do that?
You're going to do that by taking the first step on the BCMB road to graduate greatness. You're going to do that by taking classes.
The rigorous BCMB curriculum has been handcrafted and meticulously engineered to optimize maximum knowledge integration. To ease the transition into graduate learning, the BCMB curriculum begins with a simple tour of biophysical principles.
And that is the way things go.
What?
The first few core classes serve to reinforce basic comprehension of fundamental concepts in biology by combining innovative instructional techniques.
So as the particle spins orthogonally to the initial spin vector...
Ow, my leg!
Sorry.
As well as cutting-edge technology.
The beauty of biology, you see, is in seeing things in living color. To this end, I've made a movie for you. Watch very closely as this cell divides.
One of the most useful things you'll find here at Hopkins is the collaborative environment, where you can receive immediate feedback on your project from faculty as well as peers. Here at Departmental Seminar, you have a chance to listen to talks from meticulously selected speakers as well as advanced graduate students.
Oh, hey, I forgot to tell you, you need to give Departmental Seminar 2 minutes.
Hopkins Departmental Seminars have a reputation for attracting some of the biggest names in science. Past speakers have included Alex Zhang, Ken Cao, Martin Hetzer, Daniel Liu, Peter Walter, Tim Osborne, Joseph Goldstein. Who's Goldstein?
Oh, bagels!
Steve Ellidge.
Hey,
I'm sorry. Hello?
No, no, I'm filming. I'm in the middle of filming the Hopkins. Welcome to grad.
Mom, what? Lasagna? Does it have cheese? Mom, I'm lactose intolerant. Mom, I can't have lactose. Listen, I have to call you back, all right? All right. I love you. I'm so sorry about that. All right. In addition to departmental seminars, BCMB first years will get the opportunity to discuss topical papers with engaged faculty and eager students.
Hey, how are ya?
I'm psyched to go to the beach this weekend. I'm gonna play some V-ball, I'm gonna hang with my girl, I'm gonna get my tan on.
You know we have core in 5 minutes, right?
In core discussion, students enjoy the benefits of a small class size and a focused faculty member.
Can you explain figure four?
Absolutely. The real genius behind this paper, not only did the author solve the structure without any experiments, but that he did it whilst having a raging pneumonia.
Pretty soon your entire graduate career will be focused around time spent in lab. So here are some tips to help you through. Now, we don't have time to tell you everything. Just the tips.
It's important to let your advisor know that you're focused on your rotation project. The most effective method of doing this requires two things, Alt and Tab. Don't forget, that's Alt and Tab.
All right, so you want to start out by isolating the mutation in this path. And you can do this by doing a two-hybrid screen yeast.
Okay, yeast two-hybrid.
And, yeah, because the two-hybrid screen will tell you the potential binding.
It's also important to make sure that your advisor knows that you're really putting in those hours.
Finally.
Have a good weekend.
In lab, technique is invaluable, and regardless of background, before coming to BCMB, the Hopkins curriculum provides all students the opportunity to perfect skills at the bench. You should get a good night's sleep tonight. Training starts tomorrow. BCMB curriculum has to offer. You'll have tackled the acceptance process, managed to find a place to live, conquered core, fought a departmental seminar, and tamed those rotation projects. With winter fast approaching, you've earned a short break.
Dude, I'm so excited for this break. I'm gonna drink some eggnog, chill with my girl, make some snow angels.
That is, after your final exam.
What?!
Oh, my other leg! Remember, pain is weakness leaving the body. There will be no cell phones. There will be no laptops. There will be no books. There will be no notes. There will be no calculators. There will be no pins. There will be no pencils. You will have 30 minutes to answer 200 short answer questions. If you do not respond to at least half, you fail. If your answers are too long, you fail. Too short, you fail. But don't forget the curve is a myth!
Don't worry, the test won't be all that hard.
Saccharomyces? Is my copy of the test in German?
With an A plus here and a K plus there, magnesium and calcium. Oh, calcium!
What happens if I'm finished and I still have time? Can I play my Game Boy?
Of course, some people might not show up. And some will wish they hadn't.
If a grad student starts exam at 4 and is a 1/4 done, only an eighth of the time remaining, what time should he have stopped drinking the night before?
Nope. 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 Nope.
Considering an average volume of a representative nucleus, how many molecules of glucose are required to transcribe and synthesize 13 femtomolar of the single nuclear peptide MSAQSLPAAT? Short calculation for the amount of ATP required to initiate a single round of transcription, as well as pertinent energy-consuming events in translation and nuclear transport. Assume that the peptide of interest is encoded by a single exon and transverses the nucleus
biocanonical machinery. Consider equal production of each nucleotide from the pentose phosphate pathway and equal production of each non-essential amino acid from TCA cycle precursors. How many times over can a single one of your neurons complete this task based on the breakfast you ate. Calculate the number of neurons in your specific brain and moles of glucose metabolized from your specific breakfast. Assume this occurs immediately after 30 minutes of exercise at 80% of your max heart rate, including rowing, elliptical, and treadmill. Assume you have a heart murmur. Also assume you fought with your significant other last night. You didn't run as far as you wanted to this morning. You studied from an outdated textbook, and you're not as smart as your classmates. Easy.
Should there be a fatty acid in there?
Well, that about wraps things up. Just remember these lessons, and we here at Johns Hopkins BCMB are confident you can fulfill your full potential as a scientist. And no matter what, remember, don't stop believing.
Just a small town girl, living in a lonely world. She took the midnight train going anywhere. Just a city boy, born and raised in South Detroit. He took the midnight train going anywhere.